Have you ever tested what happens if you have a virtual machine with a network security group enabled on its network interface and a network security group enabled on the subnet in which the VM is deployed? In this video, I will tell you everything about it, but first, let's grab a cup of coffee and have some fun. About to leave, already packing, come with me, I'm not really asking, we'll get away. A place where we don't know. About to see the world in action. What we can be, life with no distractions. We'll get away. This is what we waited for. Welcome to a new Azure vlog. I know it's been a long time since my last video. I was quite busy doing some customer projects. My energy almost drained down to zero, but the energy is back now and I'm here for you with a new Azure vlog. In this one, I'm going to talk about network security groups and especially their strange behavior when you put them together on a network interface and on a subnet. And I will do a quick promotion on Talking Azure, a project of mine with some other friends. Let's dive into network security groups first. Dealing with network security has always been important. It was always been important in your on-premise data center, but so it is also in Azure. Network security groups are resources in Azure which you can compare with a traditional firewall in your data center. They hold access control lists. We can apply them on network interfaces and we can apply them on subnets as well. Keep in mind that I just said traditional firewall. Nowadays we have the next generation firewall which allows us to do deep packet inspection, maybe web application firewalling, etc. A network security group is not a next generation firewall. If you want to leverage next generation firewalling in Azure, that's possible, but you need a network virtual appliance for that. As I just said, network security groups are some kind of traditional firewall, an access control list. When we have a look in the Azure portal, you will see that the network security group actually contains two lists, the incoming rules and the outgoing rules. And both those rules, incoming and outgoing, are processed in the same manner. The Azure Virtual Network stack will first check if a package that's going through the network security group is inbound or outbound. Based on that, it will load a set of rules and will order those rules by the priority. We can manually enter the priority when we create those access control lists. So the Azure Virtual Network stack will first check if the package is an inbound package or an outbound package. Based on the type of package, it will load the inbound rules or the outbound rules. It will order those rules on the priority. And after that, the virtual network stack will iterate through all those rules and check if a rule matches with the package. And if it matches, well, it will allow traffic or it will drop traffic based on what we entered in the rule. Another thing that I want to tell you is what happens when you put multiple network security groups together. Let's say you apply one on your virtual network interface and you apply one on the subnet. In a traditional network, you have a layered construction. If a package is coming out of the network interface, it's first evaluated through all the rules that are applied on your network interface. And later on, when it enters or leaves the subnet, It will evaluate it by the rules that are applied on the subnet. Within Azure, that's not the way how it is working. All rules are actually terminated on the network interface. So a construction where we allow, let's say, a remote desktop port on a subnet level, and we allow other ports on a network interface, so machines can communicate within that subnet on other ports than the remote desktop port, is not possible. There are some tricks that you can do in order to get that working. I will show them in a couple of minutes in a demo. So when designing your network infrastructure, keep in mind that network security groups are only applied on a network interface. The Azure Virtual Network stack will actually some kind of merge network security groups that are applied on the subnet and that are applied on network interface together. And the product that comes out of the merger is actually being applied on your network interface. So let's go and have a look at the Azure portal and see what happens in this strange construction of network security groups. So I prepared a demo where we have a network security group enabled on the network interface, and we also have a network security group enabled on a subnet. And I will demonstrate to you what is going to happen. So let's have a look at the resources that I have deployed. I deployed two VMs, Ubuntu 1 and Ubuntu 2, that are connected to a virtual network, the Azure Vlog Demo virtual network. And on both those VMs, a network security group is applied. And we also have a network security group that is applied on the subnet. As you can see, I denied all ports on the subnet. Only port 22 is allowed from my personal IP address, so I can access those virtual machines from this notebook. Let's have a look at our virtual network first. Here we have those two VMs connected with the IP addresses 10.0.1.4 and 10.0.1.5. And when we look at the subnet network security group is applied over there. So let's dive into those virtual machines. I have them open here, so in Royal TSX. You can see it over here. And the IP addresses, they match. So what's interesting is I denied all network except SSH network into the subnet. If you would see this network as a traditional network, traffic within the subnet should be allowed. So if this was a traditional network, I was able to SSH from Ubuntu 2 into the Ubuntu 1 VM. Let's try that right now. SSH 10.0.1.4, which was the IP address of the Ubuntu 1 VM. Yeah, we can wait a lot over here because nothing is going to happen. As I told you earlier, network security groups that are applied on a subnet are actually terminated on the network interface. So we basically created a rule for this network interface, which is saying that all traffic incoming is denied, except from that SSH rule where my IP address is stated in. And to demonstrate to you that this is actually the case, I will now disable the network security group from the subnet, and we will see that I am able to SSH from Ubuntu 2 into the Ubuntu 1 VM. Let's remove that. Okay, so the subnet is getting updated. This will take a while in order to be effective. It can take up to 1 minute, I've seen. And there we go. The network security group is now disabled on the subnet. We are able to connect SSH from the Ubuntu 2 VM into the Ubuntu 1 VM. So the lessons learned today is that network security groups do not behave as a traditional firewall in a traditional on-premise data center. All network security groups are terminated on a network interface. And that does not allow us to have a layered construction of firewalls, which you would have normally in your on-premise data center. So keep that in mind. So now you know how the virtual network stack in Azure is working with network security groups. So another thing that I want to discuss with you is TalkingAzure.com. Talking Azure is a community-driven project by me and a couple of friends of mine. Which are also in the IT consultancy business. We try to upload a blog post every week, and they are on a variety of topics. They are on automation, they are on Azure security, they are on the networking, they are on virtual machines, all kinds of stuff. So, let's take a look at that website and be amazed about the knowledge that's shared over there. And with that, I would like to close this Azure vlog. I will see you, I guess, in 2 weeks, maybe earlier. I will be attending Microsoft Build, and of course I will do some vlogs from there. So, see you in a couple of weeks. Bye.